This is Lee from Top Rank. I told the team in the locker room that this is Bob's 50th anniversary in boxing this year, in 2016. And I've been with Bob for 33 years. And I told Victor, his wife, Freddie, and Vadim, it's one of the greatest wins we ever had in Top Rank history. And congratulations. That last punch is a right uppercut left hook, which is practiced daily at the wild card gym. He did it over and over again before the last round. Freddie told the corner, he's ready to go. Let's do it. And that's why Victor thanked Freddie for the strategy and the timing to throw that punch. And the reason that Victor trains at wild card, when he was a little boy, when he was 12 years old in Ukraine, his ultimate goal was to win the world a world title, even as a little boy. And then he came to America, which he calls the Mecca of boxing, and he picked out Wild Card Gym and Freddie Roach. Freddie is the world's best trainer. Wild Card is the world's best gym. And when Victor walked into the Wild Card for the first time, he was struck by the smallness of it all, but then he looked at all the pictures, all the champions who practiced there in both floors, and he knew this right spot. And it's tough to win a title. He beat a great champion, a feared fighter, but congratulations to Victor. And now I want to bring his manager up, Vadim, and he'll take it from here. Vadim?
Thank you guys for all the support. It was a great night for us tonight. I want to remind everybody who was at the press conference before the fight. I mentioned that Matthysse took advantage of Ruslan Provodnikov by bringing a style that we did not expect. And I said it was not going to happen again, and this was a revenge fight. I think I only said that by watching the camp, watching what Freddie, Marvin, Alexander were working with Victor. I knew that we were hoping that Matthysse would fight Provodnikov and make it a trilogy, and you know, Ruslan's just that type of fighter. He was looking for the brawl, he was looking for the trilogy. Victor is a higher class fighter. We knew he was going to either outbox him, and we were not going to let him outbrawl us. And I think that's exactly what Victor did tonight. He listened to Freddie, to Alexander, to Marvin. Everything they said, he did. That's a great quality in a fighter, when a fighter can do what the corner says. You know, all the opportunities are open for Victor. I can be confident enough to say that there's a new star born tonight. You know, he's the new WBC champion. And as for Lucas Matthysse, I think he'll be back to make the trilogy with Provodnikov, and those are going to be great fights. And I think Golden Boy now knows that when they offered the fight to them, they should have not denied the fight, and they should have taken the Provodnikov fight, because that would have made the better fight for Matthysse. So congratulations to Victor. I'm going to first bring up Freddie to say a couple of words about the fight and about the training camp, and then we'll bring Victor up. Thank you, guys.
We did have a great training camp. Victor's you know, hard worker, and he had great sparring partners, you know, with Frankie Gomez and a lot of guys in my gym. And that's one thing about Wild Card, dude. We had great work there, we had great sparring, and we got him ready for the fight. And you know, Max Kellerman came over to the corner, and I said, "This guy's about to quit." And he says, "Who?" I said, "Your opponent." And then 30 seconds later, I came true. So it was a great night for me, and this is my 36th world champion. Victor, thank you very much.
Конечно же, впервые за свою компанию Elitebox Promotion, всю свою команду. Хочу поблагодарить свою супругу, которая ждала меня 2 месяца. Она была дома, я готовился сам.
I want to first of all say a big thank you to Elite Boxing. They've been with me since the beginning. I want to say thank you to all of my team, everybody who trained me. I want to say thank you to my wife, Olga. She waited for me for 2 months. Now she's here and it paid off. I appreciate it, Olga.
Эмоции переполняют. Я новый чемпион мира стал. Это моя мечта. Я готов идти дальше. объединяет титула. В общем, готов драться с сильнейшими.
My emotions are overfilling me right now. I'm very happy. This has been a dream all my life. You know, 7 years as a pro, and now I'm a world champion, and I can't believe it. I feel like I'm still a young fighter. I feel like I'm ready to go, and I feel like this is only the beginning. I'm ready to unify titles, fight the best. This is a new start for me.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I don't know what else to say. If there's any questions, Viktor will be happy to answer.
What if there's one fight that you and your fighter could choose, who would that be?
Если есть один бой, который ты бы хотел выбрать следующий соперник, кто бы это был?
Мне говорили в ринге, что есть звезда в моем весе, это Теренс Кроуфорд. Я готов с ним встретиться. Но я знаю, он чемпион мира по WBO. Я готов.
In the ring I was told that there's a big star out there, and he's the WBO champion, Теренс Кроуфорд.
Вопрос, готов ли он?
I'm ready to fight him. The question is he ready to fight me?
Congratulations, Viktor.
Thank you.
In the early portion of the fight, it seemed to be a rough water. You had your moments. What did you see in him to make the fight turn the tide?
В начале боя кажется, что были тяжелые моменты со стороны Матисса. Что ты видел в нем и что тебе позволило поменять бой и взять инициативу на себя?
Вы знаете, это первый, это очень серьезный соперник, но я впервые за все 27 моих поединков, я вообще не волновался. Я выходил, у меня даже не было никакого сомнения, что я побежу, я просто выходил, боксировал и все.
He's a great, great fighter, but this is probably the first fight where I was very, very calm and I was not nervous. I knew 100% I'm going to win the fight.
Хотя я понимал, что он самый сильный и жесткий боксер.
But I knew he's probably the best and the strongest fighter. You know, people call him the best in the 140-pound division right now. You know, maybe one of the top pound-for-pound fighters. He's a great, great fighter.
Go ahead.
At one point, there were murmurs that if Matthysse had won this, that he would be fighting Pacquiao. I know you're talking about Crawford, but is there any possibility that that could happen? Of course, the complication, seeing as Freddie Roach is your trainer, but...
Были разговоры перед боем, что если Матисса бы выиграл, он бы встретился с Пакьяо. Ты выиграл этот бой, и как ты относишься к бою с Пакьяо, учитывая, что у вас один тренер?
Я готов драться, конечно же, но это все не от меня зависит, как договорятся.
You know, I'm ready to fight anybody, but it's not up to me. You know, I have a team and I have promoters, and it's up to my team and what they decide.
Mark, go ahead.
In May of last year, you fought in the Forum, and it was the same type of fight. You came on at the end and had a knockout. Is that an example of your conditioning or the fact that you're built for a 12-round fight?
В мае того года также прошел бой с Айдином. Также, в принципе, шел бой, и в конце ты его нокаутировал. Какая причина? Это твоя готовность, подготовка, кардио или стратегия?
Ну, во-первых, да, это первая была подготовка в зале Фредди Роуча, в Алкаджиме. И, конечно же, была ответственность, потому что это был элиминаторный бой. Если я выиграю, я встречаю чемпиона. Поэтому тоже была ответственность, я к этому подошел, как подошел и...
Ну почему именно оба боя прошли по одной? Это твоя стратегия или это?
Нет, моя стратегия была затянуть во вторую половину и там уже накатывать, и если есть возможность, выиграть накатывать.
Both of those fights were very important fights for me. At that time, that was the biggest fight for me because it was for the mandatory challenger position. The way the fights happened, it just happened. You know, obviously there's no secret to my strategy being to take the opponent into deeper waters and do my best in the later rounds and act in the later rounds, and that's what I did.
Have a show?
Yeah. What are you going to do to celebrate?
Что ты будешь, чтобы отметить победу?
Что?
Как отметить победу?
Как отметить? Конечно, в первую очередь я через два дня уезжаю домой. И что мы сделаем с моей супругой, это мы поедем отдохнем. Отдых, да, на море.
First of all, in 2 days I'm going home to the Ukraine, and the first thing we will do is my wife and I are going to go somewhere to the closer to the sea and take a vacation.
Этот год был тяжелый очень.
It's been a difficult year for me.
Right here, Mark. Yeah, Frank, go ahead.
You talked about one day when Manny walked into your gym and you saw that he could be great. When he walked into your gym, what are the things that you initially said, we've got to get better in order to fight on this level?
Well, actually, what I said about Viktor is, like, he's my favorite Russian fighter, but then I was told he's Ukraine, so I had to readjust that. But he is my favorite Ukraine fighter. He works hard. He's like Manny Pacquiao and all those guys. They work very hard. They're very disciplined, and that's why they're here, because they work so hard. He's tremendous dedication.
What type of technical thing did you want him to get better at?
Technically, I wanted the jab to get better, of course, and I didn't want him to just rely on the jab, though, because he does have a good right hand behind it. And he showed that a few times tonight. And, you know, the thing is, we had to work on him not getting tangled up and kind of holding a little bit too much. And the referee's giving us a little bit of a hard time tonight because we were holding a little bit too much in the early rounds. But then when I told him to use, when you fall into the pocket to use your uppercut and hook, it worked very well. And I did tell my ex-Hellerman before the fight, I said, this guy's about to quit. And he did. So I was very happy with that. But I think that has a lot to do with his condition and his sparring partners. He has a lot of good sparring at my gym, and I have a lot of good 40-pounders right now. But he's the best.
Thank you. Congratulations on a spectacular win. At any point during the fight, were you hurt? And can you rank Matthysse's power?
В этот момент в бою ты был поражен его ударом, ну что он тебя
показал? Да, я.
И можешь поставить ранг на его силу удара?
Я пару ударов пропустил в пятом или в шестом. Действительно, да, тяжелые удары, но они медленные, но они тяжелые такие, жесткие. Но ничего, я не растерялся, все нормально.
Yes, I did feel his power somewhere in the fifth or sixth round. There was two big shots that he landed. No question about it. Very, very heavy punches.
Я понимаю,
but they're not that quick. They're not that quick.
Понимаю, почему он закончил нокаутом. Вроде бы как бы не удар, но он потрясает.
There's no doubt for his record having so many knockouts, because his punches don't seem that big, but they do hurt you.
Поэтому нельзя расслабляться, я был все время сфокусирован.
But I knew before the fight I can't relax, and I was focused every minute, every round, and I made sure that I'm not taking any extra shots.
Were you surprised that Matthysse didn't?
Ты был удивлен, что он не встал?
Да, ну мне показалось, ну как я хорошо приложился, но мне показалось, что он встанет, был нокдаун, но
he's like, I did try to land some hard shots at that time. Believe it or not, I thought he was going to get up, but I guess I'm a big knockout guy also.
Anything else?
And last time I talked to you, you mentioned that the WBC belt means a lot to you and also your country of Ukraine. Now that you have it, what can you put into words what you're feeling now?
Ты говорил до боя, что для тебя этот пояс и для твоей страны, для Украины, это очень большой шаг и очень много значит. Теперь есть этот пояс у твоей страны. Что это значит?
Ну, во-первых, страна мною будет гореться. Во-вторых, я на взвешивании сказал, пояс будет в Украине.
First of all, most important, my country is going to be proud of me and what I did. And second of all, at the weigh-in I said, this belt is going to be in the Ukraine.
Go ahead. Viktor, Adrian Broner won a title tonight as well. Could you see him as a future rival for you?
Adrian Broner also won a title tonight. Do you see him as a future rival for you? Tell me that you're on this channel.
Tell me that you're on this channel. I don't know even what to say, but I want to stay on this channel and work with it.
I don't know what to say about Adrian right now, but I'm fighting on a fight network that I want to remain on right now.
Okay.
The team? That's it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
and I'm sure there's going to be more battles for him. So I want to bring him up. Lucas the Machine Matthysse. Lucas.
Bueno, buenas noches a todos. Quiero decirle que nada, que estoy bien. Son peleas, se gana, se pierde. Me tocó perder. Y nada, acá estoy.
Just want to say good evening to everybody. Thank you for being here. And, you know, you win some, you lose some. And tonight I lost.
Lucas.
Questions? Preguntas, questions.
Para Lucas.
Sí.
Bueno. Vos dijiste que peleas son peleas. Ante todo, ¿cómo estás del ojo?
Bien, la verdad que bueno, sentí un impacto, una piña en el ojo, se me tapó el ojo, no veía nada y decidí por ahí quedar ahí en el piso así.
Te quedaste sentado, pero no estaba sentido así.
No sentí el impacto en mi ojo y un estallido y pensé que mi ojo estaba mal.
The question was, first of all, Lucas, how are you? What are you feeling? Are you okay from your eye? And he said, yeah, I'm fine now. But yes, I went blind for a while. I went blind, I couldn't see anything.
O sea que fue la lesión en el ojo más que el golpe en sí, digamos. No estaba groggy ni sentido.
No estaba muy sentido. La verdad que sentí el impacto y sentí una estallido en mi ojo. Y no sé, puede pasar, prefiero quedarme ahí y seguir con los dos ojos.
The question was, were you hurt at any time? You know, was it just the eye? And he said, yeah, it was just the eye. I wasn't hurt, but I went blind. I went blind, and you know, it obviously it caused for some concern. And you know, I don't want to go blind.
Eric.
Yes.
Eric, could you ask him how badly did the clash of heads in the seventh round affect him physically?
Sí, me dio. La verdad que sí. Tengo me dio en el pómulo muy fuerte. No, sí sentí el cabezazo, pero no. La verdad que bueno, esta noche me sentí frustrado, no me salió nada. No sé qué me pasó.
Yes, it was. It did affect me. It was bad. It really hurt. And it hit me. He hit me right in the eye. And it just wasn't my night. You know, I couldn't get off. He just frustrated me. He really, really frustrated me. Francisco.
Eric, Lucas, ¿estabas más frustrado por la distancia, su alcance o más que te estaba deteniendo los primeros rounds?
Sí, la verdad que bueno, lo primero me costó entrarle al cuerpo, me encontró a la distancia. En algunos rounds pude, pero sí, la verdad que me frustró bastante, se me bloqueó la cabeza y no sé qué me pasó.
The question was, did he frustrate you because of the holding or because of his reach? And he said, you know, yeah, a little bit of the reach. It was tough. You know, it was tough to get on inside on him, and I was able to do it a few rounds. And it was just a bad night. I just didn't go my way.
Lucas, en el séptimo round lo tuviste mal. Lo conmoviste en un momento. Ahí, ese fue el round. Parece que gastaste toda la batería ahí. Desde el octavo en adelante parece que te encontró la mano.
Claro, sí, después...
Un hombre largo, difícil, ¿no?
Sí, era difícil, manejó bien la distancia, hicieron buena pelea. Pero nada, sí, por eso digo, después me frustré y no sé qué me pasó.
The question was, you know, it seems that, you know, you hurt him in the seventh round, and then after that, it's like you lost all your energy. You didn't have any energy, you weren't doing much. And Lucas said, yeah, you know, I mean, obviously... I was able to land some punches and you know, do what I wanted to do in some of the rounds, but he frustrated me. He just really, really frustrated me, and then I just lost my head. I don't know what happened.
Se pensaba que Postol te iba a enfriar la pelea, te iba a agarrar lo que hizo. Pero me parece que lo que más te debe haber frustrado es que no te dio nunca la distancia con las piernas, porque siempre estaba un paso más lejos, ¿puede ser?
Sí, por eso mismo. No le pude encontrar. La verdad que hizo un buen trabajo con mi equipo y todos vieron en Argentina el trabajo que hice, la verdad que como un sparring con todo. Pero sí, me supo manejar bien la distancia, supo enfriar bien la pelea, supo meterme en el cuerpo, quedarse al lado mío cuando llegaba y me frustró, la verdad que bueno.
The question was, you know, yeah, you know, he used his reach, but he also boxed and moved really, really well with his feet. You know, was that the frustrating part? You know, each time he got in the inside, he was able to get out. And he said, yeah, it was all of that. I have to give him credit. They had a good game plan. He used it, and, you know, he kept me away. And then each time I got on the inside and was going to start working, he grabbed me and he held me. So it was just very, very frustrating.
Cuando se termina una pelea como esta, que uno pierde y se queda con la sensación, sabor amargo en la boca, ya se está pensando en el plan B. ¿Se puede volver a Probotnikov ahora entonces? Now when you lose the fight, that, you know, it's a defeat and you are a little groggy right now, but you start to think in plan B. Probotnikov could be the plan B.
No, ahora descansar, la verdad que este año fue muy duro, entrenamiento, de pelea con Probotnikov. Esta noche fue muy dura. Nada, ahora descansar, quiero estar con mi familia, con mi hija, con mi señora y pensar después a ver qué hacemos.
Pero hay más matices, ¿no?
Sí, seguro.
The question, the obviously you guys heard the question, and he said, look, right now I'm not thinking about a plan B. Right now I just want to rest. I want to go back home and rest. It's been a long year. It's been a difficult year. The Probotnikov fight was a tough fight. I want to go and enjoy my family, my daughter, my wife, and just go rest. Right. And then the last question was, but there's still more Matthysse, and he said, of course there is.
Lucas, ¿estás considerando venir a entrenar a los Estados Unidos? ¿Es algo que podría beneficiar tu futuro?
No estoy pensando en eso. Hice un buen trabajo, hice un excelente trabajo con mi equipo, con todo. Tuve buenos sparring, buena concentración. Y la verdad que eso no. Esta noche me frustró a mi rival, me frustré yo, se me bloqueó la cabeza. Creo que a muchos boxeadores le pasa, esta noche me pasó a mí. Y no, estoy, sigo entrenando, voy a seguir entrenando en Argentina como siempre.
The question was, now after this, do you plan on maybe coming out here in the U.S. and making your training camp out here and training out here? And Lucas said, no, not at all. I had a great training camp, you know, sparring partners, everything. Everything was perfect back home, so I can't really say it was that. Again, I got very frustrated. It frustrated me, and I lost my head. It happens to fighters, and this time it happened to me.
Yes. In the Probotnikov fight, you show that you were able to box exceptionally well. It almost seemed like in this fight you were looking for the knockout. You did mention frustration, but was that part of the game plan, as opposed to wanting to knock him out, rely on that power a little too much?
Sí, entrenado para eso. Sabíamos que él iba a hacer esa pelea, que iba a mantenerme lejos, que no iba a tratar de que yo llegue. Y bueno, no me salió nada, me bloqueé.
He said that was the game plan. It was the game plan. I mean, we've studied him. We knew that he wasn't going to want to engage. He was going to kind of keep me away, use his reach and box. So the game plan was to take the fight to him. And, you know, again, I lost my head. What can I say? I lost my head. It wasn't me tonight.
Yes.
Mr. Lucas, si lo harías otra vez, ¿qué harías diferente en esta pelea?
What would you do different if you had a chance to fight him again?
Y tratar de acortar mejor la distancia y estar más metido en la pelea. Creo que se me bloqueó, se me nubló la cabeza y la verdad que no me salió nada. No sé, hice una buena preparación, hice todo bien.
¿Nunca te había pasado eso?
No, nunca. La verdad que bueno, hice unos buenos rounds, pero se me bloqueó los pensamientos ahí arriba.
¿Primera vez,
qué sé yo? Pasa.
Yeah, so, you know, he said basically the important thing is, you know, obviously you want to cut off the ring on him and you want to cut the distance. That's what you do different. But again, look, it's hard to explain, but I lost my head. I really, really lost my head. After a while, my focus wasn't there. I lost my head. And I was just fighting on instinct. Yes?
You're being put on the fast track to fight Manny Pacquiao. Was he at all in your mind throughout the training camp or perhaps even today?
No, la verdad que no, esto de Pacquiao no me alejó de la concentración de esta. Postol fue un buen peleador esta noche, perdí con el número uno, creo que no perdí con ningún muerto. Perdí con el número uno, creo que sé yo. Son peleas.
No, not at all. I mean, look, I lost to the number one guy. I didn't lose to an opponent. So, you know, No, I didn't think about that. You know, I was just thinking about Postol.
Yes, right there, yes.
Lucas, cuando Postol te empezó a impactar, ¿te sorprendió su pegada?
No, pegaba muy fuerte. La verdad que no tenía muy pegada, muy dura. La verdad que no.
The punch, they asked him about the punch, did he surprise you with the punch? Was he a hard puncher? And Lucas said, no, not at all. You know, he didn't really surprise me. His punch wasn't that big or powerful.
Sí. Lucas, el día de ayer, a menos de una hora de la ceremonia del pesaje, notamos que abandonaste las instalaciones del estado de preparación. ¿Tuviste problemas de peso, deshidratación o algo que afectó?
No, la verdad que del miércoles que estoy dando el peso, hice una excelente dieta, tengo una nutricionista en Argentina. Del miércoles que estoy dando el peso, no me costó para nada.
The question was, maybe did you have any problems with the weight? Could that have been an issue? And he said, no, not at all. Wednesday of this week, I made weight. I was already on weight. I have an excellent nutritionist back home. And that wasn't a problem at all. Yes.
Ya que tienes nutricionista y te pasó esto, a lo mejor hace falta agregar un psicólogo ahora en el grupo.
Nada, son peleas, creo que todo perdemos y ganamos. Tampoco porque perdí esa noche me van a mandar con un psicólogo.
¿Te bloqueaste?
Sí, yeah. Me bloqueé seguramente, esto es para seguir trabajando, pero no, creo que no.
The question was, you know, you have a nutritionist, a very good nutritionist. After this fight, you need a psychologist. Maybe enter the team, and he said, no, not at all, look. You know, I lost the fight. I don't need to be sent to a psychologist. You know, these things happen.
Eric, over here.
Yes.
You know, this guy, not known to knock out a lot of folk with the record that he has. This guy hit you with a shot, but did you think that you could come back after that shot?
Él este es un peleador que no puede.
No, me pegó en el ojo y se me estalló el ojo. Pensé que mi ojo estaba mal. Pensé puede haber desprendimiento de retina, muchas cosas, ¿no? La verdad que no, me quedé ahí por solamente eso. Sentí, sí, el impacto duro, sí, pero por eso, el impacto tuve en el ojo.
It wasn't so much the power of the punch, but he got me right in the eye and I went blind. I couldn't see anything, I went blind, and you know, so a lot of things ran through my mind. I didn't want to lose my eye, but I went blind. Yes.
¿Qué tan lejos ves el retiro? Has estado involucrado en muchas guerras y eventualmente vas a empezar a sentir los estragos.
No, ahora descansar. Puedo pensar eso.
You know, do you ever think of retirement? You've been in a lot of big fights, wars. And he said, no, I'm thinking about rest. I just want a vacation, think about rest.
Lucas, tuviste 10 segundos para pensar el tema del ojo. ¿Qué más pudiste pensar en 10 segundos? ¿Qué otras cosas te cruzaron? Porque en 10 segundos en la mente cruzan muchas cosas.
Sí. En ese momento no veía y quería recuperar la vista y no podía.
¿Pero qué más pensaba?
What did you think in those 10 seconds when they're counting you out? What were you thinking? What went through your head? And he said, look, I just wanted my vision to come back. I was blind. I wanted my vision to come back. That's it.
Tremendo campeón, mi campeón.
Last question. Yes, go.
Lucas, you've made mention that you lost your focus a few times in the press conference, and I think that's very easy for a fighter to happen in a fight. And I think that's when the trainer and the corner are supposed to be able to steer you in the right direction. Did your corner ever give you any insight or put you back on a path that may have made the fight a little bit easier for you?
Sí, la verdad que sí, mi esquina me estaba trabajando bien, simplemente que entraba a combate y no estuve en mi noche.
Well, it just wasn't my night, you know, they gave me good advice in the corner, and they would tell me, and I was listening to them, and they were giving me good instructions, but as soon as I went back into battle, I lost my head. It wasn't my night.
Much respect to you, Lucas.
Thank you. Hey guys, I just want to note one thing. At the time of the stoppage, it was a very, very close fight. One judge had Lucas up 86-85, and the other two judges had Postol up 86-85. So it was a very close fight at that point. And